Hello, this is a quick tutorial for using PsycInfo once you have your research question in place. This database is within the EbscoHost platform, and it is the premier database in psychology. The PsycInfo database contains scholarly journals, conference papers, government documents, and links to psych books and dissertations. Accessing it through the Johns Hopkins Sheridan Libraries will allow you to obtain full text of the articles and other resources you need for your research. In order to access PsycInfo from the library, you'll need to log in with your JHID. Once you're inside and you have your research question, you can begin searching. Our research question today will be, does playing video games during childhood affect levels of violence in teenagers? Our keywords, if we pull them out of our research question, are going to be video games, childhood, violence, and teenagers. Let's start by going into these boxes and putting in terms video games and violence. We'll add the other terms later. Notice that I have multiple boxes. If I separate the terms out by and, I'm saying I want both video games and violence to appear in my search. Let's do the search. Notice I have 1,024 results right here. Not all of your results are going to apply to your research questions, so you need to go in and take a look at them. From here, I notice that number 2 looks like a great result. So let's click on number 2 and go on into it. Notice that my title is at the top. After that, I have my authors. And you can see there are multiple authors. I have my source, which is the Journal of Adolescent Health, and all of the source information for finding that article. From there, if I scroll down, I have a lot of other pieces of information that can be valuable to me. The abstract will give me information about the article that I'm going to want to read to see if it's relevant to my research question. The document type is a journal article. And the subjects right here are APA subjects that they have established that this article is about. There is an APA thesaurus up at the top, which you can use. There's another tutorial for that. But right now, note that these are good terms that we could use. There are medical subject headings as well if you want to search in PubMed. Also, it has your population. What is your age group of your population? Did they use a specific test or a specific measure to do this study? What is the methodology? And then the fact that it is a peer-reviewed journal article, which is also important. It also gives you a link to the digital object identifier. So if I scroll back up here, you can see that there's a lot of information within here. And there's a lot of other tutorials that will teach you how to use the different pieces of this. I'm going to add a couple terms here. Aggressive behavior and computer games are two similar terms to the ones we're using right now. So I'm going to add those on the same line. Video games, or you can see it pops up computer games or gaming or online games. I could search all of these. I'm just going to put in or computer games. For right now, and then violence or aggressive behavior, and do my search from there. You can see I now have over 1,200 results. I can add my third term, teenagers. Let's do teenagers or adolescents or young adults. You can see if I wanted to add another term here, I could do that. But right now I only need this one. And I'm going to do my search. Now, we still have over 400 results. If I want to, I can drop down from select a field and click on SU subjects, because I know that these APA thesaurus terms are subjects for a few of these. Let's try that. What you're doing here is you're narrowing down your results if you're finding too many, and you're adding terms if you're finding not enough. On the left here, you can see I can limit to peer-reviewed articles. Be careful when you do that. And I can also limit by date. You might not want things from all the way back in 1983, so maybe the last 10 years. From here, you can see I've narrowed it down to 161 results. As you can see, some of these results are full text, and I can link to them right here, but some have this Find It button. If you click on the Find It, what you'll do is be directed back to the library, where it will find the full text for you, or take you to a page where you can request it through interlibrary loan. You never want to click on the Link to Full Text button, because that would get rid of things with Find It. I can add things to folders, and you can see it's adding them right to the slide over here. And if I go back up to the top, you can see I have a folder button right there, and I could sign in. This is the basics of searching in PsycInfo. There are many more limiters on the left-hand side that you can play with. You can also use the tutorial for the advanced search function. Thank you for attending.